Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today I'm going to make compression more visual. So this is by AP Mastering. They created these plugins called AP Mastering Comp View, and one's called the AP Compressor. So here I have a signal, a 96 kilohertz tone going through Proceed 2. So what we're going to do is learn all these knobs. There's basically four knobs that do the most of compression. You have a threshold, a ratio, an attack, and release. So let's turn the threshold down. And as we can visually see, the threshold is creating a range of volume. Okay, so think about the threshold as a way to control how much dynamic range we have once we start compressing. So this is that it creates the range. Okay, now if I have the threshold at zero, there is no really dynamic happening because there's no difference between the top and the bottom signal. Now once we have a threshold, we start to create this extreme curvature. So as I crank the threshold down, you guys can visually see that curvature is getting steeper and steeper. So that's what the threshold is doing visually behind the scenes to a signal. Now the ratio is a little bit different. So what we're going to do is start at 1-to-1 ratio, and we're going to set our threshold lower. Now we shouldn't get any change in the dynamic, okay? Because there's no volume difference to be calculated. So if threshold is the range of distance of the volume change, ratio is basically how fast we go from the beginning to the end of that range, okay? So as I lower my threshold, again, nothing happens if we're at 1-to-1. So as I start cranking the ratio up, we're going to see this. Now, I don't think we could visually see this, okay? Because it's gonna be how fast we go, or the curvature. Yeah, we will see it actually, because it'll be the curvature. So this is how concave the curvature is the ratio, okay? So let's turn this up. And as we crank the ratio up, we get more curvature, or more concave curvature. We're getting into the physics of all this. Look at how sharp that curve is. Okay, so as the ratio goes up, it basically illustrates the velocity from where it starts to where it finishes. Now there's a lot more to compression, like feedback and all this type of stuff. We're not going to cover everything about compression. I just want to show you guys, once you understand what the compressor is actually doing, you know what to listen for. Okay, so again, there's no audio. You guys shouldn't be hearing anything. Let's turn our threshold down. Let's turn it to a pretty basic ratio. Let's do 2-to-1. And let's do a threshold of like negative 10, so it's not super wide of a curve. Now what we're going to mess with is the attack time. So if the ratio determines that steep curvature, what does the attack time do? Okay, so in my opinion, the attack time, think of it like the x-axis. It's like how far, remember, threshold is the range. Okay, so that's the y-axis. Think of it like the y-axis. It's how high and low a sound goes. The ratio is how fast does it go from y equals 2 to y equals 0. Okay, it's the speed of the range. Now, attack time is like the x-axis. It's saying over, it's almost like a gradient, how you can stretch the gradient. So it's not super dense, you could stretch it out. We're saying, okay, over that amount of time, we want it to go from top to bottom, not just this small amount of time. So now we're stretching out the x-axis, AKA the attack. Now, again, it's a little esoteric because we're using imaginary sound right now that you guys can't hear. So as I increase the attack, you guys will notice this curvature becomes less steep and it becomes more spread out. Now let me pull this up a little bit just so y'all can see. Now, if I have a quick attack, you'll start to see that curvature go from a wide range where it goes from the top of the, think of like sledding, how you guys have sleds. You either had a sled where you had a hill that went straight down and you just kind of ended your sledding, or you have one of those big mountainous hills where it went down for a long amount of time. So think about the attack as like the hill when you're sledding. A quick attack would be like a very small hill that goes straight down. A bigger attack would be like a big mountain hill that kind of takes forever to get to the bottom. So you have a really fun time going all the way down to the bottom and you get a lot more sledding time. So this is the attack curvature. So as you see, it becomes more dull and less concave as we increase the attack, which means the sound will become less snappy. Now in context, we're going to apply this later, but the sound will become less snappy. So we're going to take all these learnings and apply it to sound. But I want you guys to visually see what's happening with the levels so that we can understand what these parameters are actually doing. Now the release time, this is a little difficult because I don't know how fast this monitor works. So this is the part where it gets a little tricky because I'm not sure the amount of x-axis that it gives us to monitor this. But let's see if we can visually see what release time is doing. I don't think we can. If we can, it's above my pay grade. It looks like I just saw it a second ago. That might have been me just lifting the level. Yeah, so release time in this case, I don't know how to visually trigger it on this specific comp view, but imagine the sound going down and then coming back up. That's what release is. It used to be called recovery because we're recovering back to the level where we started. Now it's called release, which is kind of like it doesn't correlate to what it's actually doing. So that's why it's a little tricky. So recovery is an easier word to understand what's happening. We're going to recover back to the level that we started, which is up here. So it's basically going to compress, go down, and then recover back up. So again, I don't know how to visually do that on this view. I'm still learning this plugin. So forgive me on this part of the lesson. What we're gonna do on the next part is actually run some drums and we're gonna start compressing to hear what these things sound like. Okay, so let's apply this knowledge. Again, what I love about AP Mastering's approach to showing us that plugin called CompView is that he made compression visual. To us, we are always told to hear music and listen to music. That's great for when we apply the technology, but to understand what the technology is actually doing is super important because now we know how to manipulate a sound to get what we want. What triggered my sound design brain years ago was I used to learn sine wave, triangle wave, square wave, sawtooth wave, and they just sounded different. I didn't know what timbre meant. I didn't know what overtones were. I didn't know what harmonics were until I visually saw on a graph what that meant. Like once we visually see what harmonic content looks like, what white noise looks like, why drums sound more full because of their transients and energy, it makes so much more sense. Okay, so let's visually look at both graphs here. So let's turn up the threshold. Remember, our threshold is creating the range from top to bottom. How much dynamic range do we want? That's basically what it's creating. The ratio is gonna be how fast we go from the top of that sled mountain down to the bottom of the sled hill. So hill or mountain, depending on the attack time that we set. Okay, so let's put these at zero for now, or the lowest values for now. Okay, so right now, unless the signal is going above 0 dB, nothing's happening right now. Okay, so what we're gonna do is set the range. How much volume do we want taken out of this sound? So let's pull down the threshold. Now I'm saying volume to kind of generalize here. I know it's a little bit different of a concept, but we're just going to use it as basic terms here. Okay, so let's set it to like negative 15. So we're setting a range, a dynamic range here. Now the ratio is how fast do we pull down the sound? The velocity of the sound coming down, I should say. The velocity of the dynamic range. Let's turn the ratio up. So now technically anything above this point is being pulled down. Anything above 15, negative 15 dB. I'm not going to complexly explain it because that will confuse what we already established before, which is just think of the threshold as a range, okay? And think of the ratio as how fast something goes from the top of that sled hill to the bottom of the sled hill. Okay, so do we push the kid down the sled hill? Do we just kind of gently nudge him? Do we roll down the sled hill? Are we in a fast sled? Are we in a slow sled? So this will determine how fast we sled down the hill, the ratio. So let's set this to like 4 to 1. Let's say we push the kid over the edge and now he's like flying down the hill. Okay, now the attack time is how long is the hill? Now, if you guys have ever sledded on some good hills, you know that the short hills are fun for like quickly, running back up and going back down. Run back up, go back down. Those are fun for those kind of fun. Now, the real scary ones when you have these long hills that start way up at the top of a hill and it goes on and on and on until you get to the bottom. Now, that's a journey. So we're going to pull up the attack time to make a bigger hill, so to speak, for our sled. So now the volume is going to go down over a period of time. Now keep in mind, this amount of time on paper is way shorter than you think. You might think 40 milliseconds is this long amount of time. It's way shorter than you think. Trust me, I did an experiment a while ago to measure it. And trust me, 40 milliseconds is like, you couldn't even detect it as far as like visually, I'm saying. Now audibly, we can detect about 20 milliseconds and above. If you're a pro ear, you can hear anything from less than 20 seconds. But anyhow, so now we're basically creating a bigger hill for the sled. Now release time is, I like to use the word recovery. How long does it take to bring the volume back up to normal? So this depends on tempo and the groove of your drums. If your release is too long, meaning we're not going to turn up the volume of the compressor, this is the one that I didn't demonstrate visually, so I have to explain it this way. So release time is basically like how long does it take you to climb up back to the top of the sled hill. So release time at a very fast amount is going to say you just have some magical boots on where you could run through snow. You have some snowshoes on. A longer release time is you're wearing like sneakers and you keep getting stuck in the snow and your foot keeps getting stuck and it's harder to get to the top of that sled mountain. So let's say we want the compressor to go back to the top of the sled mountain pretty fast. They have some snowshoes on. So let's select a lower release time in this case. Now, sometimes release is also demonstrated in percentage, not just numbers. So now we're audibly hearing what this means, okay? Now let's lower the attack time. This should give us a snappier sound. Remember, the attack time is how fast we go down the sled hill. So we get faster fun, but it's a shorter fun. So let's pull down the attack. So we're basically just catching the transients of the audio and pulling it down real quick so that it doesn't go above a certain point. That's kind of what I'm audibly hearing here. Now we're going to also try, I meant to show you guys different formulas that they have here in Pro C2, but basically the short of it, without going through that whole demonstration again visually, is that it changes the curvature. So all these different algorithms that they have here are just changing how fast we go from top to bottom, or changing like the range of that curvature. They're basically just doing what we just did for you. Okay, so Opto's a wider, it's like a longer sled ride from what I remember. The bus one is like going from the top of the hill to the bottom hill in like a millisecond. It's so fast. It has a very steep curve and you go from top to bottom very fast with this setting on. Punch, I forget what that one looked like. The vocal was again kind of like a slow gradual come down, and that's what I remember from the test, but you guys can test it for yourself. Let's just try the different modes and just audibly hear what they sound like. With different compressor styles, we're basically just changing the curvature of the sound. From what I remember, the Opto is a nice wide sled hill, you know, a good nice sled where you get top of the bottom and take some time to get to the bottom of that hill. The bus one was like going from the top of the hill to the bottom of the hill very fast, from what I remember. And the vocal one is kind of like the Opto one where you start up high and you gradually go down low. So once, basically they're giving us different ways of illustrating the transient of the sound. The higher the attack, the more open the sound, because we're allowing the compressor to allow the expression of the sound instead of a quick attack, which makes it sound like that. Okay, so that's what happens when we start lowering the attack. The compressor acts right away and it kind of sucks the sound out. So sometimes you need that tone though for that. So it depends on what you're trying to do. There's no right or wrong. Now with a longer attack, we're starting to hear the impact of that kick and that snare. We're just shaping the curvature of it. Now, if I have a fast attack, we're hearing that push-pull of the compressor. All right, so let me see if I can exaggerate the mix. This might get louder. Here we go. Okay, so this is what's happening. We're adding this to the sound. So if you just think about this as a layer added to your sound, you'll understand compression a little bit more as far as tonality. So this is basically what the compressor is doing to the sound. So we're just adding like a scrapiness to the sound. Once I get that that's the extreme of what I'm doing, I go, oh, how much more extension to the sound do I need? You know, so I'm not going to get into the weeds about everything about compression. I just wanted to show you guys visually what it looks like and then how we can apply it to our actual sound design. So again, if we want, just think about sledding. Okay, the threshold is how big is the hill that we're sledding on. The ratio is how fast do we go from the top of the hill to the bottom of the hill. Basically, it's kind of like, what's the snow like? Is it like soft snow? Is it hard snow? And then we have the attack time, which is how big is that hill? Like, does the hill start way up here and then kind of gradually go down over time? Or is it a straight down kind of curvature to the hill where you don't really have much like angled going downness? I don't know the proper word for that. The release time, I like to think of this like recovery. It's how long does it take for the sound to go back to its original volume? Or in the case of sledding, it would be like, you know, once you go down the hill from sledding, how long does it take you to get back up to the top of the hill? Once you think about compression this way, you're going to think about it a little bit differently. And hopefully I gave the beginners a little more arsenal. Hopefully I give the advanced people a little more perspective from a different analogy. Like this video, share with a friend, and let's help people around the world. Peace out, guys.